Hello everybody, welcome back to Drunk Happy Gamers, and welcome back to more Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. Now on the last episode, we got through our first shrine, there it is over there, and we also fought a couple of dudes, and we're looking for more shrines now. I did have a little look around because I needed some stuff to do on this episode, so I also inadvertently found another Korok seed, but that's of no real significance right now. But, yeah, I do have another traveler's bow as well, but I was looking for some meat mainly. But yeah, we're still looking for the next shrine. I know pretty much where I'm going at the moment, but hopefully this proves to be an alright thing to get done on today's episode. But I have to admit, I am super enjoying this game. I'm pretty far ahead in my playthrough, the one I'm doing on my own, really, and oh my god, I cannot stop playing it. This game has so much secrets and stuff to find in it, and I love it all. Every time I try and focus on the main stuff, I inadvertently go and find something else, and yeah, that's pretty much how it's going to be. So I'm going to I'm going to do the same as I'm doing on Yakuza, and I will try and complete get as close to completing the game as possible and record the final episode on my final file, or like the file that I've got really far on, so like you can see much more of the game than you could if I was just playing this game on its own. And yeah, that should prove to be useful, as long as I can find out where I'm going in the first place and make it to this next shrine. But I think it's taking quite a long time. It's taking longer than I expected, because I remember it being over here somewhere, and I didn't like this where I went in this particular place, so we'll see what happens. Ah, here we are now. This is perfect. So we want to approach this from the opposite side, because there's shit in here that are very deadly, and I don't like them. I don't like them in my current game, actually, but I'll show you one quickly, because one of them is about to activate. I know it. There we go. See what I tell you? This thing is a decrepit, like, guardian thing, and they fire laser beams at you that can kill you in one shot at the moment, so I'm just going to hide here quickly and find a way around that doesn't involve me getting shot and or killed. But you can go up to these, still finding me, you find stuff on them. As long as they're not active, then they give you stuff, and that's cool. We got two ancient shafts, and that's a shaft as in a rectum. Okay, moving swiftly onward and not focusing on the terrible pun I just made about a rectum and an anus of various different sizes and shapes. Yeah, so we need to go over here, and I need to quickly climb this, because otherwise I will die. So yeah, okay, so we've made it to this shrine, the Jabaij shrine. It's in, like, garbage or whatever it is. But yeah, so we open the shrine up, open the doors, and see what is contained within. As long as the cutscene just starts playing, because that would be helpful. It was better timing than I thought. It only took us like 4 minutes to get to the shrine itself, so hopefully I should be able to get most of the other ones done as well, as long as I can remember where they are perfectly well, because I'm super far ahead in the game. I can't remember where they are. So, okay, so we have this. To you who sets foot in the shrine, I'm Jabaij. In the name of the goddess Hylia, I offer this trial. Okay, I shall perform the bomb trial. So first we go over to here, because this is a guardian pillar thing, and it's going to give us something cool. That something is distilling rune. Well, it's going to give us another rune for our Sheikah slate, or our switch tablet, as it should rightly be known. Okay, so we have it now. What is contained within the rune? Bombs! Remote bombs and, like, throwable bombs or something. I'm gonna have a drink. I've got Foster's. It sucks, but still, it's drinkable. The rune has been extracted. We have all that is contained within, and now we can switch runes by doing that. So that's exactly what we're going to do. Actually, no, because this will do... I pressed the wrong button. There we go. Now we can throw it. And detonates! Boom! Okay. I really wish there was a power-up in this game that allowed the bombs to make fiery explosions, because fire is super useful in this game. And, as I found, continuing on... And we find a treasure chest! What is contained within? A traveler's claymore. Oh, awesome. Except I've run out of room. Hold on. What can I get rid of? A stick! I can drop the stick and get the traveler's claymore. Because... And I will equip it now, actually, because it is a pretty hefty-looking blade. There it is. Rawr! Nice. I just wasted some of the durability. That was clever of me. Well done, me. Okay, let's move that. So yeah, as you probably guessed from last episode, all weapons have durability. The bows, the shields, the swords, and yeah, you want to try and keep them durable for as long as possible. Hold on. Oh, crap. Throw it! Boom! Oh, crap. And I died. As I said, you're super fragile in this game, but at least you don't... That was a bad call. I was trying to switch the other bombs, but I just went with what I had, which was in my hands at the time. Let's skip this. And so I killed myself. Please don't tell me I have to get the rune again. No, I don't. It's fine. Whee! Boom. So yeah, they're bombs. Stand well back if you want to live. Thus proving the stupidness of man. Okay, we got that. So we got the claymore. Come on, bombs. There we go. Boom. I'm so glad I wasn't in that blast radius. Okay, switch to this bomb, because this is the bomb that I truly need. And we go over here, pick it up, throw it. Okay, that worked this time. Barely. That was really stupid. I did the same thing that I did before. Okay, so now that we are here, we can do puzzles and shit. I'll get my bombs out just to be on the safe side. Okay. So let's start by doing the actual puzzly thing, where we go over here and we drop that in there, knock it in there, wait for it to go down, and it shoots up into the air and I explode it, like that. Ah, there's still some left. Oh well, whatever. Ah, oh no, I tried to wall jump that, I didn't make it. Okay, so there is a ball-y thing. That's basically just showing you what you can do, but you can also do this. Wee, and I missed. Swing and a miss. Okay, so I will do this properly now. I will do the real thingy on the trial and be a good linky dink and go. Hooray, we made it to the treasure chest. I have it now. It's in my hands. What is it? An amber. And the only use I've found for those at the moment is just, like, their shit you can sell. So yeah, now we can go up this ladder because the blocks blocking the way, as they tend to do, are not a thing anymore. So, let's put that down there. Get to the furthest possible point away, and boom. Oh, they just shifted that one sideways. I've not seen that before. Ah, that's cool. Anyway. We have completed the shrine and the trial. So, yes, this is a good thing. And the spirit orb, we get. Your resourcefulness in overcoming this trial speaks to the promise of a hero. I always misread this. I don't know why. But in the name of the goddess Hylia, I bestow upon you this spirit orb. And every time it says, like, speaks promise or something like that, I always misread it for some reason when I'm reading it to myself, and it's really dumb, but whatever. We're done with this shrine and we get the spirit orb. Only two more and then we can appease the old man. Okay. And not this old man. This old man's gone. See? He's just gone, blown away in the wind. Like the decrepit, frail body that he is. A Magnesis. I don't know why they just called it magnetism, but whatever. Okay, so... Oh no! thingies. I must kill them all. Okay, and my Boko Club broke. I shall use the stick. Ha! Have some of my stick. Oh, a traveler's sword. Holy shit, that's good. It's a good drop. Like that. And there's a Boko Blin arm, Boko Club. You can grab that. And grab the Boko Blin fangs too. Oh, there's more of them. Because we can either cook them up or mix them in with like monster parts and stuff. Okay. So now that that's done, we can go out into the danger zone, which is this place. And I'm going to run because I don't want to be here. Okay. Yeah, one of them spotted me. Oh no! It attacked me. I'll attack you first. Boko Spear. Oh, I can't use it. I can use this though. Traveler's Sword. Ah! Aha! You stand no chance. Oh god. And now I'm back here again. Just die already. What was that? Restless Cricket. Oh, cool. Oh no! That one survived. How dare you survive? Okay, you're dead now. Ha! You have nothing. You have only bones that I have broken. Skeletor! Okay, alright, so on to the next shrine, which is up there. You can clearly see it, plain as day. That's good. We can hopefully get there quite easily. But first, we need to go do something. Something very specific and very useful to do. But it took me a while to figure out what I needed to do because I didn't read something. And, yeah, spoilers. So yeah, we're going over this way. I'm gonna go try and find this old man again, because we need to talk to him to help us with our problems. Yeah, so I'm trying to avoid these guys. Actually, I can show you another mechanic in this, where sometimes you want to avoid battles, you have to sneak very carefully. Try not to make any noise whatsoever, except I'll probably get this wrong and just wake him up, like I usually do. But you can get like some cool equipment later that can help you stealth a lot better. Be the stealthy snake man. Okay. Draw the sword. I don't want to take that. Not yet, anyway. Hello? 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 Come on. There we go. There's the prompt I need. The sneak strike. Hiya! And get back down again. Oh, is that a black one? No, I think it's still a red one. I think there are only red ones in this area, but still. Sneak strike! Ha! Yeah, we killed them. They didn't stand a chance. Alright, so we got another Boko club, another Boko shield, another Boko bow. I guess we can pick that. Oh no, it's bees! Oh, bees, I must run. I know. No, that's not a good idea because I want the thing. I want this thing. And I think they're coming after me now. Are they coming after me? Yes, they are. Oh no! They knocked me backwards! Bees! Get away, bees! Did I kill them? Yeah, they have dispersed. I have slain the bees! Fuck you, bees! And we get your bee honey. Yay. Honey, it's useful stuff, I think. You can cook it up and make stuff. That's pretty cool. Alright, there are enemies down there, and there's a mushroom up there that I may want to collect real quick, because I won't be getting any of these for a while. So let's jump up here real quick and get the rush shroom. Badger, 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 badger. Oh, mushroom, mushroom. Okay. Oh, that's a callback to something I haven't heard for a while. Okay, so over here we have a torch, which will possibly be useful, and a pot lid. And I can get rid of another shield for this, like this one here. Equip the pot lid because it's more durable. Well, it's slightly stronger, slightly better. And I need the old man to appear here, so I'm going to go and sleep in his bed. And oh yeah, well, why not? Let's read the diary. The old man's diary, read. On this desolate plateau, the only pleasure that brings me comfort is cooking. And today, I should be using old man voice. No, I have dispersed of the immersion. Okay. And today I outdid myself, truly. I created the perfect dish.
I call it spicy meat and seafood fry.
Spicy meat. Okay.
This recipe not only restores health, but also keeps me warm even when traveling in the snowy mountains. With this dish on my side, I no longer have need of that itchy warm doublet. I do not know how this allowed to happen. It seemed I forgot to write down a very important recipe. I know raw meat and spicy pepper, however, I simply cannot remember what else I used. My age is catching up to me. Read more. Sadly, on this lonely plateau, I only have my knowledge and memory to rely on. Still, I did find someone who knew the missing ingredient.
If I did find someone,
I would happily reward him with my warm doublet.
Okay. So, we are after that warm doublet. So we need, a woodcutter's axe. I think I may have to equip that. Oh, we have one already. But I can get rid of one of these things because they are not very useful. And chop up those, get the arrow and a spicy pepper. Oh, not bad. Oh, that's where he is. The old man's sleeping. God damn it. He's using the bed that I wanted to use. Okay, so now we can go here. No, I don't need to sit by the fire. We're going to cook up some shit. So let's hold this. Alright, so we can hold up to 5 items at a time. And we get the raw meat that I managed to catch earlier after some painstaking minutes. And we shove them in the pot! And we got a bouncy and a bouncy and bouncy, 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 boom, having such a good time. Bouncy, bouncy, shoes all in a line. Bouncy, bouncy. Oh, mighty boosh. Anyway, spicy meat and seafood fry grants low level cold resistance. So yeah, we've got that now. We might as well cook up some more stuff while we're here. So if we use this, we hold that, we hold that, we hold one of those, get that in there. Do 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 do. Yeah, we got energizing mushroom skewer. These are very useful, so we're gonna make a couple more. Oh no, that was meat. No, I can't do this. I need to put them away. Put them back, Link. You don't need them right now. Do not use this inside. Okay, here we go. Got one more in us, so we can cook this up and get another one of these energizing skewers. These are useful if you're stuck on a cliffside climbing up a place and you're running out of stamina. So then you can just pop one of those in you and restore some of that stamina, and hopefully you'll manage to get up the cliff. But maybe not in some of the cases that I have seen. Okay, he's chopping wood. We need to go see him. Old man, come here. I have need of you. As long as my stamina can hold out. Alright, hello. Oh, fancy that. So we meet again. What are you doing? I thought this tree here might make for some good firewood. However, getting a tree for... Okay. You have found my axe. Why not help me out and give it a few swings? I'm working up quite a sweat here. Sure thing, old man. I will do that for you. Because I am a nice man, a nice linky-dink. I'll use this and chop it up. Chop it up real good. And one more. And we get the wood that we can use. Oh, can we talk to you now? Oh, I see you did my work for me. Take that wood, don't be shy now. Oh, we have to wait for you to walk back to the fireplace, don't you? Okay, we'll climb this tree. Quickly. Come on, give me the apples. I need the apples. I need all of the apples. They must be mine. Okay. I'm seemingly sounding like Skeletor for quite a lot of this episode for no reason whatsoever. But anyway. Alright, we're going to go take down these monsters right here because they need to die while we wait for the old man to finally decide he wants to get to where he wants to go. Right, so if I aim this carefully like that... Kill him in one shot with a critical. I think it was a critical anyway. But yeah, we're gonna sneak up on these guys too. And take that. I missed. That sucks. Let's try again. There we go. Ha ha! You fool! It was me! I killed you. Okay, we can take the rest of these guys out with the Traveler's Sword. So let's go see what he's got over here. We've got some arrows. That's useful. Hello. I'm here. Can you see me? Yes, you can. Hiya. Oh no, that didn't work. Oh no, the durability! Durability's going badly! No! It broke. Just die! There we go. There we go. Just slash away. Okay. And we get the treasure chest that they were keeping secret for some reason. What have you got here? You got some fangs, you got a Boko club, I guess I'll pick that up. Oh, I can't have any more. That sucks. And, oh yeah, we can bomb that now, can't we? There we go, have some. Did I kill the bees? I killed the bees! Nice! That was exactly how I wanted this to go. Switching back to the Boko bow because it's useless and we can get rid of those as soon as we leave this place. Bomb arrows? That's a good drop. Holy shit. Nice. I'm going to be using the shit out of them. They are very useful items. Oh, an arrow. Nice. Oh, and a seared steak as well. We're collecting a whole crap load of stuff. We should have time for one more temple, I think, this time. And then... Oh, no, the throwing spear. I need that. Okay, get rid of Boko club. Drop that crap. And we get this crap. Yeah. Throwing spear. Yeah. Jump for joy. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. The old man should have gone to where I need him to be now. So let's head back there. And then we can finally move on to that temple up there. So. Oh ho!
A few things as delightful as roaring fire. What are you doing? Body mind is what it used to be. Recovering from a bout of hard work takes a while. If you're hungry, I have an empty pot. You can use to cook yourself a meal. I cooked something. I did it. It was me. I cooked. That looks like my signature perfect dish. Spicy meat and seafood fry. But how did you? I suppose it's not important. Can I trouble you to share the recipe? Ah, of course, Hyrule Bass. How could I have forgotten?
Well, it's kind of implied that there has to be some kind of seafood in there, because it's a seafood fry. Spicy meat and seafood fry. It's not hard, old man.
Well done. Now please allow me to award your culinary efforts with this warm doublet.
Yeah, we got the warm doublet.
With that, you should be able to resist the bite of colder environments. As for me, I know great spicy meat and seafood fry recipe, so I can do without that warm doublet.
Okay, so let's equip that, and we know some nice, cool clothing now. Sick. Get it? Cool clothing? Oh, I did a bad pun, you guys. I'm sorry. It is totally my bad. A farmer's pitchfork. We don't want that. That was nothing. Why was there nothing in there? Nothing of use, anyway. Okay, so now we need to make our way over here, because we're going to climb a mountain. And this is going to be fun, because I might fall off and die for no reason other than my own stupidity. But anyway, let's get up here and see what we can see with our little peepers. And hopefully, it won't take us too long to get to the shrine and do it, because of time restraints on the episode and stuff. Oh, we're at the Temple of Time. How did we make it back here? I didn't realise we were so close to that. Fair play. Okay, so up we go here. We're almost there. Just have to climb up this mountain here, and we should be at the shrine. So that's pretty cool, and then I'll be able to end the episode. Well, after I've done the shrine, actually. I did promise, after all. And I keep my promises. Sorry guys, took a little pause just to fill up on drink, and now we are back and we're heading to the shrine, if I can find it. I've lost track of where I am because of this pause. And you may notice that it has changed somewhat to evening time. That was a mistake, I accidentally left the game running. I didn't think it would matter too much, because I was just stuck on a wall and there was no enemies that could try and hurt me. But oh well, let's see if we can make it up here. Oh, it's going to be tight now that I've jumped twice. That was probably a mistake. I'm probably going to fall. And quite possibly die. I might be able to use the last ditch here a sec. And... Oh no, I failed it! No! No, I failed the last ditch attempt to jump up there. That sucks. Okay, let's try this one. See if we can get up this rock. We might be able to. But, as you can see, when you are at this state of the game, You are very vulnerable to the elements and also to your losing of stamina, and also the fact that you don't climb very fast at the moment. That will change at some point during this playthrough because I will be getting certain equipment that will increase my climbing speed, which will be very handy for what we will need to accomplish. And there we go. Here's the shrine. So let's get over there and get this extra one before we. Oh, there's a. I forgot there's a like a little Korok here. I may be able to do that. I'll do that on the next episode, actually, after I get out of here. Oh no! Bokoblins! Oh, that guy's got a traveler's spear. I need that. Right, let's use the Boko Club. Oh no! Oh no! They're gonna hit me off. I better heal. Luckily, I do have some of this shit, which I can utilize to my advantage. And don't you dare hit me off the thing. Okay, get that guy. Get that guy. Ah, take that! There we go. Now we can get the Traveler's Spear. This will be very useful for us because it's quite a good spear. I say quite for this early in the game, it's quite good. So anyway, into the shrine, and we can skip all this because we've seen it now. So let's go. It will repeat the same cutscenes. Let's see what shrine name is though. I can't remember what it's called because they always have these long-winded name things, naming conventions, I guess. So skip that. And we have the Stasis Trial, the Owadime Shrine. Okay, Owadime. What does that mean? What could that have implications of? Owadime. I know dime is a American coin. Ah, well, we're getting a new rune anyway while I figure this out. Owadime. I have figured out that it has no real significance whatsoever. Anyway, right, what do we get? We get the stasis power-up for our Sheikah Slate. And this, with this, we will be able to freeze stuff in time and in place. So let's get this out. Do this. Now, there we go. And now we can run safely across. That was lucky, got the timing right on that, otherwise I'd have to wait for it to circulate again. Okay, so now we have the Indiana Jones kind of shit right here. The giant ball of death. How familiar. Alright, so we need to run. I think I can make it. Yeah, I can. Nice. Right, so on this one, I just have. Ah, there's a treasure chest up there. Better go get that quickly, because that will prove useful for this upcoming. Adventure, I think. It's not really an adventure, it's more like just a puzzle. But yeah, that ball's gone. Oh, a traveler's shield. Inventory full. Great! Fantastic! Oh yeah, I forgot it's not here that we need. It's not here we get the item that is specific for this puzzle, but we should be able to get it just over here. Let's not run out of stamina because that will slow me down and I might get hit with a giant ball of death. That wouldn't be good. Okay, alright, we have lots of stuff that we actually want. Okay, I guess I'll just drop that axe because we got two of them and we get an iron sledgehammer. So, better equip that bad boy and let's use it to overcome this task like this. And we freeze it in time, we start hitting it, smashing it around a lot, and when time runs out, it'll blast off into oblivion. Cool. So we have. Oh. Thank you, Ball, for covering up the shrine's exit. Thanks for that. That was great. Okay. We have got here, we have made it to the spirit orb, which this Owadime person is going to give us to us. And what is with their like hats or stuff? They always have like these hat kind of crap on their backs or some kind of shit like that. So yeah, he offers us a spirit orb. Thank you, Owadime. And now evaporate. You must die. You must fade away into obscurity, never to be heard from again. Okay, now that's done, we can exit the shrine. So yeah, I think that'll pretty much do it for this episode. We'll tackle the last shrine in the tutorial stuff on the next episode, and then we'll do the rest of the stuff that comes with it in terms of story progression. So, anyway, thank you guys so much for watching, and if you like the episode, please stick your thumb where everyone can see it, and I will see you all in the next episode. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye. Spin the hammer round and round where it stops. Nobody knows.